Global shipping costs have jumped roughly 300% in the past year, pushed higher by the Houthi rebel attacks in the Red Sea and the conflicts in Gaza and Ukraine, which have forced shipping companies to bypass the Suez Canal and sail much longer routes around the Cape of Good Hope. Higher shipping costs results in higher prices of goods in Australia, which adds to inflation. I caught up with Simon Heaney from the UK-based Drewry Maritime Research Group a little earlier.
Right, so it's been on a roller coaster. Ever since, actually, if you take it even further back, if you go back to, COVID, obviously they went through the roof, stratospheric. Then we had Putin's invasion of Ukraine, and that affected the cost of living and pushed up energy prices and squashed demand. And then we saw basically freight rates from then on in were trending downwards fairly substantially. That was the end of the party in terms of freight rates for carriers. And that was kind of the way it was going. And then we had the Houthis attacking shipping. Obviously, we had the initial trigger for that was the situation in Israel and Gaza in October. And then carriers decided that they could no longer risk their ships, their cargoes, their crew, and they had to divert away from the Suez Canal, away from the Red Sea, go around the Cape of Good Hope. Saw a spike then in freight rates in about January. So that completely reversed that sort of previous two-year trend. And then it was pretty short-lived, actually. For 3 months, solid rates again started trending downwards slowly week on week. And that led to an assumption on our part too, that the market had adjusted. There were no, you know, more red flags for disruption ahead. Everything was just going to be relatively plain sailing.
Okay, so what has happened in recent months to cause shipping rates to start rising again?
We've seen a big spike again from early May. And so now freight rates, if you look at our Drewry's World Container Index, which is a benchmark of 8 different trade lanes on the east, what we call the east-west container trains, that's from Asia to Europe, Asia to North America, and between North America and North Europe, we've seen basically a doubling of spot rates since the end of April till the end of June. So yeah, big spike out of the blue, and it's not just limited to the east-west container trades. It's essentially its ripple effect have gone much further reaching and have hit virtually every single trade lane that you can think of.
Yeah, and I guess the question is, are rates now going to remain pretty elevated for the rest of this year, or what's it going to take for rates to start coming back down again?
So I think the honest answer is we don't know. We don't know. I mean, there's a lot of concern that freight rates will reach the same levels that they did during the pandemic. We're a long way from that yet. We're about half at current levels in terms of if we're looking at the East-West World Container Index, it's about halfway to reaching the peak that it reached during COVID. So there is some way to go, but it is increasing at a rapid rate every week. And we reckon, you know, if it carried on that momentum, that pace, you're looking at maybe 18 weeks or so before it was to reach that sort of level. So we've sort of identified 3 potential scenarios. The first one, which is the best case scenario, is that there's a swift end to the Houthi attacks on shipping and ships go back through the Suez Canal. And in that scenario, that would basically free up a lot of the latent overcapacity that does exist in the container shipping world. And we would expect freight rates to come down fairly sharply. And then another scenario, and this is our base case position. This is what we think is more likely, although I would say it's a bit of a toss of a coin between the one I've just outlined and this one, is that actually, demand continues to go. You get the more traditional third quarter peak season. Volumes grow quarter on quarter into the third quarter. Port congestion actually gets worse than it currently is. And that creates more shortages of equipment availability, and that pushes up rates. So they're the sort of two more realistic scenarios. And I think in both scenarios, rates, spot rates, will remain elevated for some duration. And in one scenario, maybe they plateau in the more positive scenario. And in the second one, we think there's still room for them to increase, sadly. But as I say, whether they reach that level, I'm not so sure. I don't think port congestion will get anything as bad as it was during the pandemic. There aren't. So the differences are that during COVID, the reasons for the congestion were across the supply chain, not just at port and at sea. They went inland as well, trucks, rail, warehousing. There were, you know, staff shortages due to COVID absences. We're not seeing that now. So those pressures aren't there.
Look, I'm obviously in Australia, the Asia Pacific market. Is there any big differences between what's going on with shipping here and what's going on with shipping rates around other major ports in other parts of the world?
Cargo only importers in Australia are feeling it just as badly as they are elsewhere. And Australia is, after a couple of lean years in terms of sort of demand growth, is one of the faster growing regions. So in our predictions, we have the Oceania region as a whole, so that includes New Zealand as well, probably for this year growing in terms of its total port throughput, only second to North America. So it's a very fast growing, coming from a low base, but it's a fast growing zone. It's had port issues recently with strikes and what have you. So all of that, you know, is going to contribute, that extra demand is going to contribute to the snarling up of equipment, because it's really all about getting those empty containers back into China, Asia, as quickly as you can. And at the moment, they're struggling. And another, I guess, one of the things I should have mentioned, that there is another positive, is that the manufacturing of equipment, the steel boxes, is ramping up in China. So that will feed into the system too. So again, there are some positive hopes that things may not get quite so bad.
Simon Heaney, thanks so much for your time.